Hey everyone, it's Sonic Wolf, and welcome back to more Wii Sports Resort. In the last episode, we did waveboarding, which is a favourite of mine. And in this episode, we're going to do Frisbee Dog. Now this one, I rarely even played this one, to be honest, because I really suck at Frisbee in this event, and also real life. Okay, so, I'll actually do manual, but there's automatic, which is for beginners. I'll actually do manual so that I won't make this too easy. So, all you have to do is you have to throw the frisbee in just like what it shows you. Okay, so it's gonna give you some steps. So, I'll do a few attempts of doing a practice run and then I'll... I'll do a few basic attempts. So you hold B and then do that. Hey, I didn't do too bad for my first try. Okay, so it's based on the angle and the curve you throw it, so it's pretty simplistic. Alright, now let's do the actual thing. Balloon practice, I'm not going to do that. There's a little bit of a trick that you can do to pop balloons without throwing a frisbee into them. So, 1, 2, 3, go! That was a little too far. Okay, Okay, so what did you guys do this week? I didn't really do much this week besides, making a script and... I'm out of breath for a moment. I'm basically trying to learn, like, editing skills and stuff like that. I've also watched about the entire series of Super Sentai, which is basically Power Rangers in Japan. There's a season I liked, which is Geoldo, which is a good season. It's not perfect. I actually will highly recommend it for you because it is an animal-based season. It has the Minecraft popularity, and basically the characters are very likable. I'm really hoping that people could actually adapt this season into Power Rangers. You know, for me, I would actually love to act as one of the characters in that season. I do like to be like red because red's my favorite color, but the actual ranger I would like to be in that season would be the yellow ranger. I'll explain why first. There's a little trick you can do. If you press the A and 2 button together, then this happens. Magic! That is really cool. You can instantly pop balloons. So you don't have to throw a frisbee. I never actually thought of that. Yeah, so that would be really, really cool to have this trick. Yay! The kind of reason I wanted to act as the Yellow Ranger for that season is because the kind of personality that the counterpart, Leo, his personality is very similar to the one I usually have, which is the wild, crazy nature, strong-hearted, and basically good at martial arts. He could be a really cool character. I really hope that the writers and producers can actually make all the characters in that season good. And check it out! Woo!
Way to go!
Yeah, way to go! Okay, so last one. Pop, and then throw the frisbee! Yep. Was pretty decent. Okay, I believe the highest score you can get is 1500 in frisbee. Yeah, so that's probably the highest score in this one. So that's Frisbee Dog.
Congratulations!
Yeah, after I saw that kind of trick about, you know, popping the balloons, I actually wanted to play that one again and do it on manual. It'll be quite fun. Now, next one is Frisbee Golf. This is the one I actually play a lot. Like, I actually love this event. Like, so much. Let's pick a different guest. Let's try guest F. Just something random. And I'll actually change the style to automatic to kind of show you the difference. I'm basically left-handed and that's pretty much it. Now, there's three different options. There's 18 holes, which is basically 18 holes in the entire course. 9 holes is basically the 9 courses in different sections. This is Resort, which is all new. And this is Classic, which is basically, you remember it, golf and the courses in Wii Sports, right? So let's go for Resort so we can see the kind of differences to them. Okay, so let's look at the stamps here. I only got some of them here. So under par, which is very simple, skip to safety. This one is very tricky to get. So you basically get the frisbee, hit the water, and then get it across the surface. That one's really tricky. Rolling goal, which means you throw the frisbee and it will basically roll on the ground into the hole. Hole in one, I can easily get. Clean 18, now this one is very hard to get because you basically have to do all 18 courses without getting in the water or out of bounds. I wouldn't say it's impossible, but I will have to say it's very difficult to get the last stamp. So it's just like golf in general, you just pick a frisbee. So let's go for this one. So you basically measure, hold the B button. Now automatic, you don't have to use the B button, you can just throw it. Sometimes automatic can be a hit or miss. Sometimes you can throw in the wrong direction or basically swing it very short. I actually use automatic quite a lot of the times, but manual is a bit more controlling, if you like. Yeah, see that? I'm really afraid to use automatic because it would throw in the wrong direction. And there we go! Yeah, way to go is what the announcer would say. Okay, last one. And there we go. Great birdie. Okay, so I got the under par stamp, which is nice. Okay, let's see if I can do a hole-in-one in this. And please don't screw this up. Good. Good. Ah, so close. Did I do it? Okay, so I got another stamp, which I think is across the water one. Come on, you can swing a little bit harder than that. Ah.
Nice approach.
Yeah, thanks for the announcer. Would actually say that.
Great par.
I forgot to turn the volume down on my computer because I heard it from my laptop. That is very stupid of me. Anyway, this one is probably the most ranged course, about 525 yards. I don't know the actual measurements in this country because, yeah, because they basically measure it in American standards. Because I remember in baseball for Wii Sport Resort that they actually measure it in meters. And oh no, I'm out of bounds, damn it! Alright, I guess I have to go to the lazy route, just do it here. At least it did a curve, I don't actually didn't go out of bounds at that point. Besides the previous attempts. That was mean. And of course we got a tree. Now, let's see if I can throw it this way. I'm left-handed, so it'd be really tricky. One, two, three, go! And that isn't too bad. Yeah, if that would have slided into the goal, then that would have been another stamp. Alright, let's try this one, and YOLO! You YOLO too hard, you flying UFO. Alright, I'm gonna try this another try. So, one, two, three. Feels like I'm gonna sneeze. Hit it. Oh, are you cereal? That is just mean. And I hit sand. All right. There we go. What? What? Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? Okay, so I got plus four, which is just brutal. Okay, please let me get a hole in one. I wanted it so bad. Good. Good. Yeah! Yeah, so we got 3 stamps in 1 try, even though it's a me that is basically gonna be erased, which really sucks. But at least I got it on film. Well, not on film, it's basically the recording capture. Now, some of the courses are basically very, very wonky now. And I'm not quite... you suck, game. Alright, let me change directions. And there we go. Also, you can notice there are some palm trees in some of the courses, which I really love that feature. You know, because it's... How do I describe it? It's basically like an island base as such. Alright, please let it get over the water. You know, I actually got the stamp of where you can get that across the water, and it didn't make it. Oh! No. What a hazard. I hate water hazards, as Beavis would say, that sucks. Or no, that was Butthead, sorry, wrong person. I still watch Beavis and Butthead, it's still possibly one of my favorite 90s type of cartoon shows. I highly recommend you watch Beavis and Butthead if you like that kind of humor. It's very different from The Simpsons or Futurama, but Beavis and Butthead were basically a phenomenon in the 90s. However, they're also very controversial, especially when they put a house on fire, it happened in real life. They basically always say, burn, burn, as such. You know, breaking the law, that type of thing. So basically some of the episodes are basically censored, which sucks, because I really hated episodes that were basically uncensored while airing, while people have to censor those scenes, like, after they were filmed. I honestly hated that. One example I do actually remember, which is basically Power Rangers Time Force, where it was filmed in 2001. It's still a good season. I would recommend it to you. However, the series was actually censored because of... because the buildings were actually censored because of the whole 9/11 attack, which was actually reasonable. Same goes for, like, some of the movies, I guess, was Lilo and Stitch. I haven't seen that movie, but there was a bonus feature of what the original material was like. I did watch the counterpart, which is Time Ranger, which is a very good Sentai season, and I would highly recommend it if you wanted to watch it as a beginner. Yeah, Time Ranger is good, the characters got more developed. Unfortunately, Rancic doesn't exist, for example, and you get to watch some of the original material that was lost in the censored version. Did I make it? No! Nope. What is the Frisbee, like, skipping stones? I don't think Frisbees are, like, skipping stones. Come on, get it to the goal! That was way too close. Okay, so we got 2 holes left. Now this one, I honestly hated this one. For golf, it's tricky, but Frisbee is worse. If I don't get a hole in one in this, I'm gonna be in big, big trouble. And I nailed it! Dun dun dun! I think Frisbee golf is probably a lot easier if you're trying to get hole-in-ones, but it's actually a lot harder when you're trying to get the distance you want. With golf, it's a lot easier to make your moves, but it's actually harder to get hole-in-ones because you know what I mean, basically. Okay, so that's really good. Also, I really forgot to mention that the hole area where the goal is, it's basically more distance with its radar, and I actually really like that kind of feature, because imagine putting a frisbee in that minimum sized golf hole, that would be almost impossible to actually do. I'm really glad the designers can actually do something like that. Can I make it? No! Oh, I really forgot to mention to this. You see that water right there you just noticed? If I pause that and do a screenshot. That lake right there, it looks like a fried chicken leg. I'm not even joking, it almost looks like a chicken leg. Okay, one last one. Go! God damn it. And I'm really glad that me can actually stand very, very still, even when the ground is actually on a curve. Double bogey! Okay, the final results is +3, which is okay for this, but even though it will be erased. 328 level points? That is insane.
Congratulations!
Okay, so I got one, I got two, got... Wait, just two? How did I get two? Wait. Hold on. I actually remember I got 3 stamps. That doesn't make sense. So I finished any course under par in less than... Oh! Now I understand. I think I might have understood what that meant. So basically you need to get 0 or the minus number in order to get that stamp as a final result. So I guess that makes sense. That kind of sucks. So, next time on Wii Sport Resort, we are going to do archery, which is an okay game. So, see you guys there.